Sometimes when they change, you can actually heal them. And we need to take the blue. Always keep visual. Oh crap. Oh crap. I did a boo-boo. Yeah, I actually killed it. Yes, we're going down memory lane from doing Cat's Rudibus 8 years ago and see if I can remember some of the details. And try and help with some tips and tricks how I do Cat's Rudibus and what to look out for. There's multiple ways to do it. Just have enough damage and power creep it all the way with multiple billions of damage. But that's not actually fun, in my opinion. And you can go with a party with overall enough damage, but the mechanics is a little bit different when there's multiple people in there. And you can go in with just enough damage, or a little more than just enough, and try and learn the mechanics that way. You can actually learn some of the base mechanics in the normal version of Rudibus, but there's a few different attacks in Chaos version. And I'll go into detail with each of those. Yes, Pierre is actually going to be less HP than Chaos Queen, and it's going to be 80 billion HP and 80% PDR. And that is not that much. It sounds like a lot. He changes phases and he can do double damage. You can also heal the other guy, but he got two phases basically. Actually three, but he got three different body parts: purple, blue and red. Purple you do normal damage to, blue and red you do double damage to or heal them, depending which head you have. And you can see it in two ways. You can actually see your head physically on your character. You have a SPR hat, but sometimes the graphic box out and you can see it in the top right corner up here. You can see the hat up here, most likely to the top right. Which color hat you have. 75% HP is he splits into the colors, and at 25% left, or 30%, he's gonna split into two phases, in the second phase or third phase, where there's two Pierres. Where in normal version of Rudibus there's only going to be one, but in Chaos version there's going to be two. And if you kill one of them and don't kill the other one within like 5 seconds, the one you killed is going to respawn with 25% HP again every single time. So you cannot just kill one and then kill the other 1 minute later. You need to kill them at the same time basically. And I have a few tricks how to do that. One is just gonna be just like power through the thing without actually splitting it into the body. At 30% you just take it down in one go. And the blue Pierre spins around with fire damage and it's got touch damage as well. And whenever you touch the body spinning around or the fire damage, it does fix it damage, not percent based. So you need, like, I'd say suggest 15k plus HP. He does a lot of damage, actually. The red Pierre teleports and just chases you around. Here's where the party play comes in different. Red Pierre, when red Pierre disappears, it's gonna teleport to where you stand and smack you and one-hit you. If you're in a party and it disappears, it's gonna take a random member of your party and teleport to that person. So if you're like five people, or like let's say three people, or four people, including you, these portals here, these three portals and myself, is where my party is standing. Red Pierre is right here. Whenever Red Pierre disappears, he can appear anywhere of these four places. So what you need to do, don't stand anywhere where those four people is. So whenever someone says teleport, or you see the teleport, he disappears, look instantly where your party members is and yourself, and just find a place where there's no people standing at that point, because he'll teleport to those places. So that's basically how you need to do that. And that also means always have visual contact to the red Pierre. If you don't, you could instantly get, you could instantly die from it teleporting out of your view sight. But let's actually get into the game and try this out. This is also the boss you most likely want to start with here. Yeah, it's a little difficult, but if you don't have the damage, you can start with this and actually start to gear up. You'll get a bottom in here. Strangely enough, hat, bottom, top, and weapon. Why these ain't switched around, I don't know. So it will go top, up, and down. So let's, we can also pop up inside. Caspia is actually going to be spawned when we enter, so you need to buff out, up out here if you need to buff up. And if you need to use any potions, I'll actually just do that. There we go. And you're ready. And it's going to be purple first. And oh yeah, there's also dropping hats. The hats will actually stun you, or put you into a lock. I'll actually try and show that, if I can. Like, then you need to press left and right and survive. That could be a little tedious. A little trick, if you have dark side, that will actually prevent it. So, you can actually trick him, like going back and forth a little. Oh yeah, that's the attack instinct. Aha. Uh-huh. You can just... Ugh. It's a little difficult on this character. On Phantom, it's much easier. Like, he'll attack close range. So, I'm just gonna get rid of him. Not. Okay. So we need to get to next phase. This is, could actually take some time, if... But after this, it's going to be really fast. Okay, now he's red. Always have vision. When he disappears, just go away. And he can... I was maybe a little too close, but... He can... He's going to one-shot you now. Okay, now I flash jump. I don't exactly know where I am, but whenever he disappears, the destination is always determined when he disappears, not when he appears. So you know when he disappears, where he's gonna pop up. And this can take a little time. And you can see on the head, it's red, and you can also see it's red up here. Sometimes the HP bar disappears, but you just need to let him hit you, not with the attack he's gonna find out now. But sometimes when you get close to him or he hits you, the HP bar is going to pop up. Okay. And let's say, take an example. He's red and I'm red. So if you see blue numbers, he's going to heal. So don't attack him there. Same color hair, same color hat as the color of the Pierre. Don't attack that. And if you have an AoE attack, you need to, not right now, but the two of them, when they drop two, you're gonna split them apart, and there's a few ways you can do that. Oh. Okay, now I have the right hat. You can just go crazy on him. Oh yeah, poison damage can also let you see where he is. And he's gonna change again. Okay, now he's blue. This is a very good stage because you can do a lot of damage here. And you can see the HP bar. You don't want to get him further down than I have now. If you want to just outpower him, I might have a little too far. But around that thing, like the fifth number, or right here, that means, can I get his HP bar? No? Yeah. Sometimes his HP bar comes and disappears. This is a good placement. Because I'm blue and he's red. And he's also gonna knock you, so bring all cures. And this is the phase, the reason why we picked blue instead of red to attack men, because he's gonna be out here all the time. And now he's gonna split into two. That's gonna be double the amount of things. Okay, he disappeared, so you need to get away from him. Okay, I need to take him down a little more, but if... Okay, don't hit anymore, like this is way too far down. This can take a long time to actually get the... I have the blue far enough down now. The red one needs to take it down a little more. So, and I have the reason why. So we need to wait until the red one switches into blue, or my blue hat switches into blue, but now I'm blue and he's blue, the one I need to hit. And walk into him. You can see the HP bar on the blue one. Sometimes they switch visually. You can normal attack to see the HP bar, because normal attack for most classes don't do much damage. And right now, if you have a single target like me that is plus one attack, you're gonna hit both. So you're gonna heal one and damage the other one, which could maybe be good for something. And now I'm a little in doubt. I think I need to hit red, actually. Right. Yeah. Okay, I hit the red. Good. Okay, now for splitting them apart. He teleports to the right. We're gonna take the blue one to the left, and then we can attack a little. Maybe not the most optimal. Okay, he teleported to the left. Let's go that way. This was not good. Sometimes when they change, you can actually heal them. And we need to take the blue. Always keep visual. Oh crap. Oh crap. I did a boo-boo. Yeah, I actually killed it. So it's gonna respawn with 25% HP. Which is bad. Yeah, this one I should not hit anymore. Oh, it's the poison damage that took it down. And then I normal attacked it. Oh, that's not intentional. So I need a blue hat for the red, or a red hat for the blue when they switch. Remember, when they switch, the HP bar also switches around. So the red one, right now, has like a lot of HP. And now they switch, now it's the blue one I need to take. But I have a blue hat. Always keep visual confirmation on the red. The port. This could be multiple minutes of waiting. So if you have enough damage, take them out in the last 30% or something. Like from 30, go to 0 if you can. And if you need to, wait until you can do it. Is this the right color? No? No, it's not. It's red and red. Okay. And teleport. Need to hit the blue one next time. Oh, I don't switch hat. Yeah. I don't think I switched hat. This is a good... Okay, don't hit it more. Now we have a trick. How can we kill both? How can we kill both at the same... Oh. How can you kill both at the same time? Just stay a little off the middle and die. Because the middle, if you... Okay, when they respawn, don't click OK right away before they disappear. And just... Go crazy now. There we go. Because when you respawn, if you don't have a hat on, you have a neutral damage, so you can damage both of them at the same time. You could do it like when you, if you have a timer, like I say, it's 30 seconds, 1 minute. I think it's 30 seconds each phase is, or each before they switch. And you can kill one right when the switch is, and when they switch is, if you need to hope you get the right hat, and you can kill the other one within like 5-6 seconds, but most likely not gonna happen. So the reason I stand a little to the side here is because if I stand here and I die here, they are gonna be here. So whenever I click OK to revive, I'm gonna spawn into them and instantly get hit by the blue Pierre's lock skill. So I can't actually use any skills. So I need to take care of that first. I need to flash jump away. But if they are right here, or on the left side, they have a little time before they spawn here. So I have a little time to actually buff up and whatever I need to do, if I need to do that. And the red one is most likely going to teleport instantly. So you just teleport to the blue, use your hyper skills and just go around and do whatever you can. You should be able to take them out most likely as easy as I did with your hyper skills. And remember your drop pendants and holy symbol. I use that and attack it in the middle. And all of the party members should be ready before you do it. And in here, you are gonna get these piece of mockery, and that's gonna give pants. Well, let's see if we get anything good. Not really. And that's the pants in here. And next up is gonna be Fun Bun. And thanks for watching. Don't misbehave. See you next video.